Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. If you enjoy my style of teaching, then I suggest that you contact me about having some on-site training at your organization. But anyhow, this episode's going to be about constexpr unique pointer in C++ 23, and perhaps a little aside as to why it took until 2023 for us to get this feature. This episode is sponsored by JetBrains. Besides yourself, who knows your project best? Your IDE. This is what makes AI Assistant and CLion, a C++ IDE by JetBrains, so context-aware and helpful. Wondering how to adopt C++ modules into your project or link to a selected library in CMake? Send your question to the AI chat. Its answer will take into account the technology you use and your project context. Need to research an error? AI Assistant and CLion can explain a runtime error, a CMake execution failure, or a selected piece of code. Want to improve your code? AI Assistant will suggest a refactoring and generate documentation for you. Learn more at jp.gg/cbp_AI. Okay, to start with, I'm just going to create a very simple, unique pointer implementation that does not support the custom deleter. Okay, so this is a pretty straightforward implementation of unique pointer. There's a few things to point out if you're perhaps not familiar with templates and C++. The first is that this is a templated type, which means it can be a unique pointer to any type, pretty much. The second thing is that these references to unique pointer here as function parameters, these do not have to explicitly be templated. I could do this if I wanted to, but it gains us nothing. I'm just saying it's all right to create this thing with a rValue reference of the same type. This is in fact an rValue reference. It is not a template function. It is not a deduced type. This is not a forwarding reference. These are all rValue references. Here, are our value references. I'm not going to delve all the way into what an R value reference is or what it means, but I just wanted to point out that unique pointer is conceptually pretty simple. The main thing we're missing is the destructor. Now, note that everything that needs to clean up the lifetime of this object that we have ownership to is defined in terms of reset. So unique pointer calls reset. Reset is incredibly simple. It just calls delete data and then sets data equal to null pointer. And it's safe to call delete on a null pointer, so we may as well just do it that way instead of checking. That doesn't gain us anything. And then I have implemented the move constructor in terms of standard exchange. This is not something that the standard would do probably because it introduces another header dependency between two different standard library types. But I'm saying that my data becomes other data, which is the pointer from the other thing. And then I'm setting other data to null pointer. So you can kind of see the code flow in this direction. Null pointer gets moved into data, data gets moved into my local data. And I did approximately the same thing with the move assignment operator, but I was careful to reset myself first so that I don't accidentally create a memory leak. Okay, conceptually, that's unique pointer. Now, let's just say for the fun of it, I wanted to do something like I want to create one of these things in a constexpr function. Oh, and I accidentally called unique pointer of the standard library instead of my own. I want to make sure I am using my own. I expect that I'm probably going to get a compile time error here because I am calling unique pointer, which does not have a constexpr constructor or constexpr destructor in a constexpr function. Variable of non-literal type, unique pointer, cannot be defined in a constexpr function before C++ 23. Okay, I am in C++ 20 mode. Now, it says that this is not literal because its destructor is not constexpr. Okay. So I will make its destructor constexpr. Constexpr function ever produces a constant expression. Why? Because I've got a non-constexpr constructor to unique pointer called a constant expression. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and make this constructor constexpr. And while I'm at it, I'm going to go ahead and make the default constructor constexpr as well. But now that compiles. Perhaps you see where I'm going with my point here. To make the move constructor constexpr, I just need to add constexpr to it. To make the move assignment operator constexpr, I simply need to add constexpr to it. And to make the reset function constexpr, I add constexpr to the reset function. Now, there's no reason for me to make the explicitly deleted operations constexpr, but I certainly could there if I wanted to as well. And this is a pattern that I am seeing over and over again. As of like C++ 20 and 23, generally what we're finding is that to make code constexpr, you simply need to add constexpr to it. And you'll see this code is compiling in C++ 20 mode. So as to why unique pointer didn't get constexpr until C++ 23, it's basically because no one submitted a paper to add constexpr to unique pointer in C++ 20. Absolutely could have been done in C++ 20. We had constexpr allocation, constexpr destructors in C++ 20. This is not complicated. Which brings me to a best practice of mine. If the code is already in a header anyhow, just make it constexpr. You will find 99% of the time, all it takes is literally just adding the constexpr keyword to it, and then that opens up a whole new range of possibilities for how we might actually use our types in constexpr code. And you might be sitting here thinking, yes, but I have no use for unique pointer in constexpr code. Which brings me to the third point that I would like to make. You might not see a reason for unique pointer to be constexpr. I certainly have seen use cases for this. I push constexpr to its limits every time I program in C++, pretty much. And I've worked with a lot of people that I well respect who have done similarly, and they find very interesting use cases that actually have considerable performance and binary size implications in their code, in good ways, that is. So you have to do this base work of enabling constexpr in your core libraries so that your users can find the constexpr use cases of your libraries. It's not going to be immediately obvious to you, but it might be to them. So thank you for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. I hope you enjoyed it. Be sure to subscribe, leave a thumbs up, etc.